Today, we are looking at the top 10 REITs to buy now, and these REITs are on fire with a 16% return in the last month alone. If you're looking for quality REITs, you found the right channel. By the end of this video, you are going to understand REIT investing and how and why REITs can be an important part of your stock portfolio to help you make some serious profits. And to put this in perspective, if you would have invested in all of these REITs exactly 1 year ago, your return on investment would have been 50%. That's a crazy ROI, and that's what we're talking about today. Of course, I'm not a financial advisor, and this video is for entertainment purposes only, so grab a cup of coffee and join me because this is not your normal stock channel. All right, let's make sure everybody understands what a REIT is and how and why it can make a great investment. What is a REIT? REIT stands for Real Estate Investment Trust, and REITs are companies that own income-producing real estate, which can include apartments, warehouses, self-storage facilities, malls, and hotels. Think of a REIT as investing in real estate without having a mortgage. What are the requirements to be a REIT? A REIT needs to return a minimum of 90% of the taxable income to shareholders as dividends each year. Invest at least 75% of the total assets in real estate or in cash. Receive at least 75% of the gross income from real estate. And they need to have a minimum of 100 shareholders. Let's go over the pros and cons of REITs. The REIT pros are steady dividends, high returns, good liquidity. It's much easier to sell REIT stock than actual real estate, and they have lower volatility than traditional stocks. The REIT cons are REITs have a high debt ratio, they can have low growth and capital appreciation. Since REITs pay so much of their profits as dividends to grow, they have to raise cash by issuing new stock shares and bonds. REIT dividends are taxed. The REIT themselves pay no taxes, but investors have to pay taxes on those dividends. To avoid taxes, REITs are perfect for tax-advantaged accounts like a Roth IRA. How is it possible for REITs to have higher than a 100% payout ratio? This can happen because of numerous tax write-offs REITs have, like depreciation. Let's jump into the new Beast Mode REIT spreadsheet. Here we go. Hello and welcome to the new Beast Mode REIT analysis. I just built this bad boy edition of Beast Mode and it is going to tear up some REITs. So today we're going to be going through IIPR, which is Innovative Industrial Properties, AMT, which is American Tower Corporation, IRM, Iron Mountain Incorporated, AMH, American Homes, IRT, Independence Realty, ILPT, Industrial Logistics, which is Gladstone Land Corporation, MPW, Medical Properties Trust, Getty Realty Corporation, GTY, and GMRE, which is Global Medical REIT. For the year-to-date stock gains, we can see these percentages coming in, and our best one is LAND, ticker LAND, at 25.18%, and overall these stocks are up 1.93% on the year. The return over 1 month, the best is IIPR at 25.78%, and on average, all of these REITs are up 15.62% on the month. And for the return over 1 year, all of them are on the positive side, and the average up percentage is 13.41%. Being a new Beast Mode analysis, let's go through some of the different fields. Under REIT info, we've got cash from operations, and CFO is the money a company brings in from ongoing regular business activities, such as manufacturing and selling goods or providing service to customers, and this is in millions. We've got total dividends paid. And remember, REITs pay out 90% of their taxable income, so that's why this number is so high. We have the beta ratio, which is risk volatility, and ideally we want that number to be around 1 or lower. And then I also include a 5-year beta, since REITs are really good for long-term investments because they have a huge tax savings if you own them for over 1 year. We have the relative strength index, which shows whether or not they are overbought or oversold. So if the relative strength index is at 70 or above, it's generally considered to be overbought, which is a good time to look for a sell signal or to take profits. And if it is at 30 or below, then it is generally considered oversold, which is a good time to buy or consider buying. And then for REITs, the debt ratio I like to look at is the net debt EBITDA ratio. And this ratio is really important, and you just have to understand that REITs carry a lot more debt than stocks do. So higher numbers here is normal, but of course, the lower the number, the better. How we analyze REITs and stocks varies, and with stocks, we want to be looking at earnings and earnings ratios and things like that. With REITs, we want to be looking at funds from operations. And FFO is a measure of the cash generated by a REIT, and the FFO formula is net income plus depreciation plus amortization minus gains of sales of property. One of the most important things when analyzing a REIT is the payout ratio, and we want that number to be generally speaking, as high as possible, and ideally we want that to be between 70 and 90. So a good payout ratio for a REIT is typically 70 to 90, and remember earlier I talked about how you can have a payout ratio above 100%, and that's because of the numerous tax write-offs like depreciation that REITs have. The margin is also important, and the higher the margin, the better. For REITs, the best measure we can use for analysis is the adjusted funds from operations. And these are based on funds from operations, but is considered preferable for analysis because it takes into consideration and is more accurate for estimating the REIT's present values and ability to pay dividends. Generally, the adjusted funds from operations equals funds from operations plus rent increases minus capital expenditures minus routine maintenance. The payout ratio is a very important thing to look at, and I prefer the adjusted funds from operations. A ratio over 100% means dividends are higher than projected income from future operations. The REIT can be required to pay dividends from the cash reserve. Now, this is not a cause for concern in the short term, but it can be a cause for concern if it extends to the long term. This will be unsustainable for the REIT and requires an adjustment of the dividends payout. So here we can look at the payout ratios, and on average, they're coming in at 91.7%, which is crazy good, and that's the real benefit of REITs. We can also look at the forward payout ratio, which is another useful metric to use, and here the average is 74.3%. REIT dividends are a major reason why people like to invest in REITs, and the dividend yield is going to vary typically between 5 and 10% depending on the type of a REIT. Our REITs today are coming in with an average 4.8% yield, which is pretty good, and we can see one of them right now, IRM, is coming in at 8.35%, and high dividend yields are not uncommon for REITs. The REIT book value information can be very helpful whenever we're doing side-by-side comparisons, and that information is here for you. You might want to pause the screen and review this. And the following data points and metrics, these are all in yellow, are a carryover from the beast mode stock analysis, as many of these fields are applicable. I would always want to look at the net income margin, and here we can see our best net income margin for any of these REITs is IIPR, at 53.76%, which is quite impressive. And I'd also like to look at the return on invested capital. The higher the number, the better. And our last section is the balance sheet. And this can help us determine how financially stable the REIT is. And I would want to look at the total assets versus total liabilities. And here, the higher the ratio, the better. So we can see everybody is coming in here pretty strong. IIPR at a 4.878 ratio, which is really nice. And our weakest one would be IRM at 1.09. And of course, the more assets we have compared to liabilities, the better. And then Patreons, they have a special bonus section dedicated just for them. I put a lot of work, time, and effort into every one of my videos and my data research, and if you appreciate them and want to see more, then all I ask is for a like and subscribe. Thanks a lot. Let's keep this channel growing. And if you want a copy of my Beast Mode spreadsheet, it's available on my Patreon page, and there's a special bonus section just for Patreon members that's worth its weight in gold. The cost is only $20 per month. All right, without further ado, let's get on with today's picks. Number one is the Gladstone Land Corporation, ticker LAND. Number two is Medical Properties Trust, ticker MPW. Number three is Global Medical REIT, ticker GMRE. Number three is American Tower REIT, ticker AMT. And of course, I'm not a financial advisor, and you will always want to do your own research and draw your own conclusions. And for my Patreon sections, your bonus section today is packed and stacked with some killer data that's going to make these selections jump off the page. Plus, you have a special bonus pick that might pay for a lifelong membership to my Patreon page. This special REIT just for you has a 206% year-to-date return and a 365% return over 1 year. I know, crazy. You're welcome. I hope that everyone enjoyed today's video. Be sure to give me some YouTube love and sound off in the comments below. And if you've not already signed up to Webull, be sure to check that out. You can get 2 free stocks valued up to $1,400, and that link is in the description below.
If you have not already, make sure you sign up for Webull to get a free stock worth up to $1,400. Webull is much more than a free stock trading app, and I have a free tutorial video on Webull that's so good, Webull actually called me after viewing it. Both the promo and Webull tutorial link are in the description below.
Thanks for hanging out with me today, sending love your way, and I'll see you soon on a fresh new video.